Hello children, in the previous class I think that Mrs. Rupa had taken the first chapter of this lesson on plant tissue. On behalf of you all, I thank her for giving valued points on that topic. Now I am going to take animal tissue. Children, do you know that how the living organisms are made of? They are made up of many cells which forms a tissue, many tissue which forms an organ, many organs together form an organ system, and finally these organs form an organism. The study of tissue is known as histology. The types of tissue are simple tissue and complex tissue. In simple tissue, a group of cells that are similar in origin, form, structure and work together to perform a specific function. Complex tissue is a group of cells different in structure and function but coordinate to perform a specific function. Animal tissue can be grouped into four basic types on the basis of their structure and function: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue and nervous tissue. Now, in this chapter, I am going to take epithelial tissue and connective tissue. Epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue are widespread throughout the body. They perform the covering of all body surface, line, body cavity and hollow organs, and are the major tissue in gland. They perform a variety of functions that include protection, secretion, absorption, excretion, filtration, diffusion and sensory reception. In epithelial tissue, there are two things to keep in mind. The cells in epithelial tissue are tightly packed together with very little intercellular matrix, because the tissue form covering and lining the cell have one free surface that is not in contact with other cell. Opposite the free surface, the cells are attached to underlying connective tissue by a non-cellular basement membrane. This membrane is a mixture of carbohydrate and protein secreted by the epithelial and connective tissue cell. There are two types of epithelial tissue. Simple epithelial tissue, composed of single layer of cell resting on the basement membrane. Compound epithelial tissue, composed of several layers of cell, only the cell of the deepest layer rests on the basement membrane. Next, we are going to learn about the functions of epithelial tissue. The skin, which forms the outer covering of the body, protects the underlying cell from drying, injury and microbial infection. They help in absorption of water and nutrient. They are involved in elimination of waste product. Some epithelial tissue perform secretory function, that is secretion of sweat, saliva, mucus and enzyme. Simple epithelial tissue. The cell in this tissue are tightly packed. They stuck very closely to each other, so close they look like the continuous sheet of cell. Secondly, the tissue lack blood vessel. All the nutrition needed for the cell is supplied by a layer on which epithelial cell lie. Since the layer is present on the base of all the cell, it is called basement membrane. Types of epithelial tissue. Types of epithelial tissue is based on two factors: number of the cell in the tissue and the shape of the cell in the tissue. Number of cell. In this tissue, if there is only one layer of cell, we call it a simple epithelial tissue. If there are multiple layer of cell, like you can see here, called as compound epithelial tissue or stratified epithelial tissue. Stratified means placed or formed in layer. Based on shape of cell, they have three varied. First cell or flat square like floor tile, it is called squamous epithelium. If it is cup like as ice like, known as cuboidal epithelium. And third is rectangular column like, called columnar epithelium. Position of different types of epithelium in our body. Squamous type of epithelium is found in the lining of the lungs and skin. They have square like cell. The skin has many layers of squamous epithelium, but only one layer in lungs. Why skin has multiple layer? That is, skin protects, hence it has many layers, whereas the lining of the lungs has single layer of cell. That is because during respiration we take in oxygen. The oxygen first enters in lungs and from there it is transported to blood. For its transfer it needs only one layer of cell. Next type of tissue is cuboidal epithelium. Cuboidal epithelium is present in the kidneys and it also lines the ducts of a few glands like the tear gland, salivary gland and sweat gland. The lining of the kidney has just one layer of cell in this tissue. It helps in absorption of waste material from our blood to excrete them out of the body. Simple cuboidal epithelium filters our blood for toxic substance and the duct or tubes of glands of sweat and salivary gland have two layers as they have to protect the duct from damage. So stratified cuboidal epithelium is made of two layers of cells only. Next one is columnar epithelium, is otherwise called as rectangular cells. Columnar epithelium lies the organ of the digestive system like stomach, small intestine and large intestine. So in digestive system we can see simple columnar epithelium. The second type of tissue is made of columnar cells, is thick layer of cell. It look like the multiple layer, so it is named as pseudo stratified columnar tissue. Pseudo means false. The next one is cuboidal, and columnar epithelial cells have hair like filament on the top of each cell. The hair like filament called cilia, but not all cells in cuboidal and columnar tissue have cilia on them. Just a few places in our body where movement of particle is required. Example, foot pipe in our body have cilia. Ciliated columnar epithelium, as it helps to push down the food into the stomach. Next one is stratified squamous epithelium, makes the skin has protein, that is keratin. Because of this protein it makes our skin waterproof. Glandular epithelial tissue. Glandular epithelial cells are specialized epithelial cell that perform the function of secreting hormones, sweat, mucus, enzymes and other products. Two types of glands are exocrine or duct gland and endocrine or ductless gland. Some of the columnar or cuboidal cells get specialized for secretion or called glandular epithelial tissue. The types of glandular epithelial tissue are unicellular, seen in glandular cell in alimentary canal, and multiple glandular cell is seen in the salivary gland. Next one is compound epithelium. The compound epithelium is made of more than one layer of cell and thus have a limited role in secretion and absorption. Their main function is to provide protection against chemical and mechanical stresses. They cover the dry surface of the skin, the moist surface of the buccal cavity, pharynx, inner lining of duct of salivary gland and of pancreatic duct. Connective tissue. It is one of the most abundant and widely distributed tissue. It provides structural framework and gives support to different tissue forming organ. It prevents the organ from getting displacement by body movement. The component of connective tissue or the intercellular substance is known as matrix. Connective tissue cells and fibers. Connective tissue can be divided into three types: loose connective tissue, dense connective tissue, and specialized connective tissue. In loose connective tissue, the cells are loosely arranged and fibers in the semi-fluid substance is distributed all over the body and support tissue and organ from strain and displacement. Example, areolar tissue and adipose tissue. Areolar tissue, it has cells and fiber loosely arranged in semi-fluid ground substance called matrix. It takes the form of fine thread crossing each other in every direction, leaving small spaces called areolae. It joins skin to muscle, fills space inside organ, and it is found around muscle, blood vessel and nerves. It helps in repair of tissue after injury and fixes skin to underlying muscle. Adipose tissue is an aggregation of fat cells or adipocytes, spherical or oval in shape. It serves as fat reservoir. They are found in subcutaneous tissue between internal organ around the heart and kidneys. They act as shock absorbers around the kidney and eyeballs. They also regulate the body temperature by acting as insulator. Dense connective tissue. It is a fibrous connective tissue densely packed with fibers and fibroblasts. It is the principal component of tendons and ligaments. Tendons, they are cord-like, strong structure that joins skeletal muscle to bone. Tendons have great strength and limited flexibility. They consist of parallel bundles of collagen fibers between which are present rows of fibroblasts. Ligaments, they are highly elastic structure and have great strength which connect bones to bone. They connect very little matrix. They strengthen the joint and allow normal movement. Specialized or supportive connective tissue. The supportive or skeletal connective tissue forms the endoskeleton of the vertebrate body, which protect various organs and help in locomotion. The supportive tissue include cartilage and bone. Cartilage, they are soft, semi-rigid, flexible and are less vascular in nature. The matrix is composed of large cartilage cell called chondrocytes. These cells are present in fluid-filled space known as lacunae. Cartilage is present in the tip of the nose, external ear, end of long bones, trachea and larynx. It provides support and flexibility to the body part. The study of cartilage is chondrology. Bone. It is solid, rigid and strong, non-flexible skeletal connective tissue. The matrix of the bone is rich in calcium, salt and collagen fibers, which gives the bone its strength. The matrix of the bone is in the form of concentric ring called lamellae. The bone cells present in lacuna are called histiocytes. They communicate with each other by a network of fine canals called canaliculi. The hollow cavity of space are called marrow cavity, filled with bone marrow. They provide shape and structural framework to the body. Next tissue is fluid connective tissue. The blood and the lymph are the fluid connective tissue which link different parts of the body. The cells of connective tissue are loosely spaced and are embedded in an intercellular matrix. Blood. Blood contains corpuscles, which are red blood cells, that is erythrocyte, white blood cells, leukocytes, and platelet. In this fluid connective tissue, blood cells move in a fluid matrix called plasma. The plasma contains inorganic salt and organic substance. It is a main circulating fluid that helps in the transport of nutrient substance. Red blood corpuscle, that is otherwise called as erythrocytes. The red blood corpuscles are oval-shaped, circular, biconcave disc-like cell and lack nucleus. When mature, they contain a respiratory pigment called hemoglobin, which is involved in the transport of oxygen to tissues. White blood corpuscles are otherwise called as leukocytes. They are larger in size, contain distinct nucleus and are colorless. They are capable of amoeboid movement and play an important role in body defense mechanism. They engulf or destroy foreign bodies. WBC are of two types, granulocyte and agranulocyte. Granulocyte have irregular shaped nuclei and cytoplasmic granules. They include the neutrophils, basophils and eosinophils. Agranulocyte lack cytoplasmic granules and includes the lymphocytes and monocytes. Blood platelets, they are minute, anucleated, fragile fragments of giant bone marrow called megakaryocytes. They play an important role in blood clotting mechanism. Lymph. Lymph is a colorless fluid filtered out of the blood capillaries. It consists of plasma and white blood cell. It mainly helps in exchange of material between blood and tissue fluid. Children, next part of the lesson will be continued by Mrs. Chitra.